in 2009, I had my first heartbreak. I was living in Copenhagen, I was working in Danish television, and I was studying history of art on the university. My boyfriend, during some years, he left me, and I was really sad. I was unhappy, I felt low about myself, I become a really unhappy person. I have never seen myself as naive, but I have to admit that in the following months after he broke up with me, I became more and more negative. My self-esteem was dropping, and people around me started to notice that I was not the best version of myself. Then luckily, one day, my mom, she came up to me and she said, "Katrine, why don't you go out for a run so you can get some of this negative energy out of your body?" And I replied, "No way, you know I can't run." Then my mom, she smashed the hand to the table and she said to me, "Then you have to learn how to run." I went online to the internet and I found a running class in the local fitness center. It was on the treadmill 2 times a week, 6 o'clock in the morning, with a coach. I went there and I really struggled from the beginning. The first training was super hard. I went into the class thinking, I'm 24 years old, I can run 10K an hour. No way I could. After not even 2 minutes, I have to jump off the treadmill. I was standing like this on a treadmill, I could see around, other athletes running way faster than me. And then the coach came over to me and he was super friendly and very calm and he said, "It's okay to lower the pace." Oof, I was really, really angry with myself. I was super disappointed that I could not even run this class without jumping off the treadmill. But I came back the week after, and I came back the week after, and I came back the week after. And slowly, as my physical shape became better and my running shape improved, so did my positive mood. I found out that every time I ran, then I got this positive feedback afterwards. And that was what I started doing, trail running. I actually ran quite a long time on a treadmill before I went out to the forest to compete. The first running competitions I did, it was only to go to the finish line. There was never a time and never a ranking in my mind. I just wanted to test my body and test my mental shape to see if I could do it. And of course, I'm also kind of competitive, so I did it as fast as I could also. But in the beginning, it was only to make it to the finish line, because I found out every time I reached that finish line, I got this positive success feeling afterwards. So how did I end up here in Lausanne and in the mountains? And how did I become one of Denmark's first ever mountain runners? Coming from Denmark, I'm born and raised in one of the flattest countries in the whole world. The highest point is 170 meters above sea line, so it's really flat. I saw one day on YouTube a video from a discipline called skyrunning. Two guys running on a ridge up to a high point in the Dolomites in Italy. And I fell in love with this sky race even before I did it. I signed up to compete in the Dolomite Sky Race in 2014. And I went to Italy to stand on a start line only with one purpose. I had two purposes, to finish and to have fun. And this is how it looks when it's fun. I did the Dolomite Sky Race and I also finished. And it was an overwhelming great experience. When I came to the finish line, I was super happy and so super positive that I could manage this race. And I was still living in Denmark at this point. And I came back from the Dolomite Mountains and I was fueled with energy for being a better mountain and sky runner. So I got a new coach and I tried to train as hard as I could, going up in the early mornings, going out in cold rain. I was still working 100% at Danish television, but I forced myself out every time I could train so I could go to the next big challenge in mind. And every time I had a hard time in my life, in my training, I knew that the light in the end of the tunnel was to go to one of these big sky races. In 2015, I did Sagama Marathon in the Spanish Pyrenees. This was also the European Championship in sky running. And this came to be an even bigger experience than I thought was possible. I finished the race, but it was with many, many learnings on the way. I thought I was prepared for this race, but I wasn't. I have watched that video over and over again. I have read the profile from the race and the description of the race. But living in flat Denmark and training on the flat grounds, I could not at that point imagine what it is to run so many vertical meters over such a long distance. This is on the way up, and this is how it looks like when it's not fun. I was almost passing out on the summit. The paramedicines wanted to take me out of the race. I was low on sugar, I was low on energy, but I said to them, I want to finish this race. So it was with tears in my eyes, in cold rain and fog, that I forced myself down that mountain to the finish line, because I wanted to finish. And I told myself, I cannot quit this race. I have trained all winter with one goal in mind, and this is this race. If I leave the race unfinished, it will take a bigger and greater deal to swallow that than to swallow off that physical pain it is to run this race. And this is how happy I am when I come to the finish line. After Sagama Marathon, I realized that I am in love with this sport of skyrunning, and I want to see how good a mountain and skyrunner I can become. But how can a mountain runner live in a country without mountains? It's like being a sailor without the water. So I packed up all my beloved belongings and I moved to the Alp. And this included quitting a really good job in Danish television and go out in the unknown. To be a professional athlete, it takes a lot of new things to adapt to. Do I get a salary? How do I train vertical meters, not kilometers? What about the new languages? What about new insurances? All these things I had to adapt to when I moved to my new environment, and that was the mountains. But I have never regretted any of my new challenges, any of the things I have to face to become one of the great skyrunners. I know that I don't quit, and I know that nobody can do it for me. And when I come to a physical or mentally summit, I know that when I've climbed that and I come to the other side, I will be rewarded with positive success feeling. I will feel stronger and I'll feel more experienced. And when I'm looking back on the time I spent on the treadmill, going up in cold, rainy mornings, 6 o'clock in the morning, to go to the treadmill with a horrible heartbreak, this determination is what I also use in my professional athlete career and in the rest of my life. Thank you for listening.